We love chitranas. Chitranas basically means flavored rice. Anything you do with rice, with some of vegetables or eggs or chicken, we just love it. And when you give the name biryani, we love it even more. Hello, namaste, salam alaikum, sasriya kal. Welcome back to another session with your wash chef at vareva.com. And today we're going to make Haryali egg biryani. This is very simple. We're going to, every time I make one recipe, I use a different technique. You know, I can blanch it and make a paste. Now I'm going to saute it and make a paste and make a nice Haryali masala or chutney to make our biryani. For making this recipe, first we're going to add some oil. We're going to saute a couple of ingredients. And here I've got kebab chini. This has got nice cinnamon and clove flavor, garlic and green chili. In this we're going to add mint. We're going to add coriander, some ginger. When you call it Haryali, you better give some nice green color, and the easy one and the best flavor you get by using spinach. Instead of blanching, you can use this method. This also gives a very good color, and just saute it for like a minute or two and all the greens will become nice and soft. By sauteing the spinach, you will be able to make this into a nice silky paste that will help you make very good Haryali biryani. Now, add some oil in the pan. In this, add whole garam masala, cardamom, star anise, clove, cinnamon, bay leaf. In this, we're going to add some ginger garlic paste. You can add some shahi jeera. While this sizzles, we're going to add the paste, the spinach, the mint, and the coriander paste. Immediately, you'll get this awesome aroma that is because of the mint and everything. This is very easy recipe because, you know, everything gets done so easily and fast. In this, add some yogurt. To make our lives very simple and easy, you can use the store-bought biryani masala or you can use the masalas what I have shown you in many of the videos. Here is the biryani masala. One more ingredient is some brown onion. To this, add salt. Make sure this masala is slowly cooked. You know, without the lid on, keep cooking so that you can retain the maximum green color. In this, add turmeric. Turmeric also will enhance the color of green. For making any biryani, a simple formula, add a little bit of oil. Make sure the water is like sea salt water. That's when you get the perfect taste. Add soaked basmati rice into this water. Once you add the rice, just mix it once so that nothing gets stuck at the bottom. Cook the rice till it is nice and done. The rice beautifully dancing in this water. I just switch it off. Look at this grain. Perfect. Lot of times what we do is we let this rice sit in this water for another 2-3 minutes so that it will have a nice shock and the rice will become even more better. Some of the oil coming out of this masala. This is all nice and perfect. All I have done is I have taken half of the masala out. We're going to add the eggs. You know, just drop in the boiled eggs. Along with, even with some water falling, that is fine. We need that extra moisture. Put the rice on top. Don't worry, some water falling, that we need because the gravy is slightly thicker. Let's sprinkle some brown onion. That will give a very nice flavor. Once again, the very flavorful our paste of this Haryali masala. Pour this masala on top. Add rest of the rice on top. Add some more brown onion. If you want, you can also go with a little bit of saffron color. Cook this on a medium flame for around 4-5 minutes and switch off the flame. Even though rice is almost 90% cooked, you can see how the heat is forming the steam and then these water droplets will fall down and that will help the rice cook perfectly. Our biryani, you know, when it is done hot, you let it dumb like this and you have to let it sit for 5 minutes so that all the juices, everything get absorbed and the rice gets cooked perfectly. See, the rice, it will slightly turn. That means the moisture is perfect and done. You know, always whenever you're serving, take the top rice on the side. I punctured the egg a little bit, but look at the way the egg is. See, even the yolk has to be nice and yellow. That's when it is perfect. Look at the rice. Get the eggs. Put them. Then take the top layer of the rice and sprinkle. The top layer of the rice will give you, you know, multiple colors, and that is what this awesome biryani is all about. I always prefer some brown onion, and that will give a very nice aroma too. Wow, magic with Chef Mani. Whether you use a spoon or not, for me biryani means great food. So I told you earlier, we love all kind of chitranas, various flavors, and this is one of them for us. You call it biryani, pulao, anything, we still enjoy. So the rice, so the whole idea is to eat very flavorful. If you overcook the eggs, you know, then the eggs will start smelling. So when you make biryanis, boil the eggs just for 7 minutes. Remove the shell and then another few minutes in the biryani making, and the yolks will be perfect. I have made Bombay style egg biryani. This is the Haryali style of egg biryani, because a lot of people ask me, you know, you make chicken Haryali, why don't you make egg? So I've shown you, make it, eat it, and keep saying whatever.